Look, I need to air some grievances. Do I have the floor?
All right, the floor is yours. What do you want?
I know you're not stupid. Don't treat me and don't treat my partner like we're stupid too, okay? What you've been saying about us on commentary is insulting. We're wrestlers. We are fighters. We are not jokes. But you parade us out there in latex suits and expect us to be happy coming in to work? Who do you think you are?
No. My friend, who do you think you are? Okay, you're coming into my office and talking to me like this? I didn't hire you, and I damn sure didn't want to keep you. But you know what? I always saw something in you. Tucker on commentary. We always saw something in you, Steve. Hell, even Adam, your partner as of late. You guys beat the TTPD together. I don't appreciate the way you're talking to me like I am the general manager who hired you, but I do respect the hell out of you for coming in here. But as of right now, you two don't have contracts, okay? You don't work here.
Give us a shot. Give us a match. One match. We want to earn our spot here. TTPD, anybody.
Well, the TTPD are not here tonight, but I will see what I can do, okay? I'm not going to promise anything, but I will see what I can do. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pulse. That encounter that you just heard was from earlier today. It's a good thing I had the production crew in there. We were in a meeting when Stephen Parker came in. If you're not familiar with that name, I know you're not familiar with that voice. One half of the former Gimps, and I'm going to try and distance myself from that because the man who confronted me certainly reminds me nothing of Gimp Steve. But before we get further into that, Tucker, you are here tonight, but also, just to let everybody know, you are a little bit under the weather, so...
A little bit? I don't know if you can tell by my voice. It's not doing so good. But I feel like hell, but it's nothing compared to the hell that Joe is going to put Martin Wittman, into.
Yeah, this is the match that we were supposed to have last week before Typhon decided to break Adonis, or Adam now, and the ring into multiple pieces. I feel like, now I'm not going to get into like Jesse Ventura conspiracy theory here, but I don't know, I just got this sneaky feeling that maybe Joe Crusoe told Typhon to do something like that and get him off the hook for this match. What do you think, Tucker? I mean, you're connected with them. I want to know the scoop.
I mean, it's possible, but...
So you don't know anything? You don't know yes or no, one way or the other? Okay.
I don't have an answer for that. I can't comment.
I mean, it was a completely freak incident. I certainly didn't see it coming. Despite all the weight in that ring, we had about 800 pounds almost worth of weight flying around that ring and being tossed around. So it could have happened.
I wonder if Otto is going to be
fish around for more money. Otto absolutely better be paying for that ring. He hasn't paid it off in full yet, but I expect that money soon, Otto. If not, I'll put you in a match where you're going to pay something off. You're going to pay for something, I'll tell you that. Martin Wittman rolls out of the ring. This is a huge opportunity for the kid. Now, the last time we even saw Martin Wittman in the ring, I believe, was against Otto himself, and he came up with a big win. Very impressive, but then again, it was Otto.
No, what? Turn around, Joe.
Martin Wittman is right behind Joe. Joe, well, notices him now. Gets clocked in the face with an elbow. Martin Wittman has got a fire.
Stepping on the title. No respect for him.
The ref gets that title out of the ring as soon as possible. We're going to start this thing off fast and furious. I did not think the kid had it in him to confront Joe like this, but he is right in his face from the get-go.
I'm just in absolute shock with Martin Wittman to that title. Stepping right over it. That's disrespectful.
I do not think he intended it. I think it was more the heat in the moment type thing. Joe throws him out of the ring and now he's just mocking him, telling him to get right back in. Now, do you think Joe is feeling the effects from that false count anywhere match at Autumn Blaze? Because it's only been 8 days removed. And a match like that, that's probably going to take a long time to just, you know, get to 100%. He got brutalized.
Oh, yeah, he won't be 100% anytime soon, but that doesn't matter. Martin Wittman's a punk. Won't do anything.
I don't know. I wouldn't take Martin Wittman for granted. He's definitely got something to prove, and he's showing it early here tonight, scooping a slam on the champ. If Martin Wittman becomes the heavyweight champion of the world of CME, I got to say I would be a little bit surprised. That would turn this company upside down, I would think. He does have a contract now. I have signed him, so he's not just some outsider anymore. He earned that by beating Otto. But, you know, in your first, you know, real official match for the championship, Joe handpicked this opponent. This is not me. Martin Wittman would not have earned a title shot in my eyes just from beating Otto. It's really just Joe, you know, trying to get the easy way out, essentially.
Well, I don't know if that's true completely. I mean, it could be him just trying to show off the talent. Say, hey, Martin Wittman, get up here and show us what you can do. I know that you're not going to be able to beat it. Yeah, I know you're not going to be able to beat me, but hey, I'm putting you over by letting you go up against the number one.
Well, I got to say, that's an incredible spin on that story. If that's the case, I am truly shocked. But Joe Crusoe, either way, is seeing what Martin Wittman has to offer. Huge roundhouse kick. You know, I got to say, I think he really is feeling the effects. He's on the defensive a lot in this match. Grabs the ropes. The ref didn't see it. Joe had a power out of that one at two. If I'm Joe, maybe I'm lucky that the ring broke last week, because if this match happened just one day after the false count anywhere, who knows how long this match would have lasted. Martin got him underneath. Nice Northern Light suplex by the rookie. Stomping in the gut now. Oh, this is something else. Joe Crusoe has been on the ground for at least like 80% of the match, and he just got the suicide dive. His head hit the barricade.
Oh, God. Martin, no, I don't want to look.
Martin is just, he's feeling it. The crowd is behind this kid. I thought he was going for a Lama. He's fall cradle, but no, he's got the arm. Oh, no.
That's not necessary.
He could have pulled the shoulder right out of its socket with that move. The fans are pumped up. He is playing to the crowd right now. I don't think he's ever had a reaction like this before. I mean, he did for me when he beat up Otto, but that's just me. These people are about, you know, they feel like they're about to see a new world champion here. Oh, Joe finally gets a counter. He finally can get some offense in of his own. Oh, no. Throws the kid back first into the wall. Turned him upside down. Now into the stairs.
That's going to hurt. That's ribs. Payback.
Yeah, his ribs just hit the corner of those stairs, the sharpest part. Could very easily slice open his stomach. Oh, he's coming back in there with a knee to the gut, though. And Joe throws him back into the wall again. Misses the boot. What's Martin got? Oh, an uppercut to the back of the head. Joe hit head first on the wall. Got to break the count. He's getting in the ring. Will he be getting back out? Yep. He does not want to win this match by count out.
Yeah, no goals for count out.
Hoisting Joe up now. Joe is just not, he's not looking like himself. Normally we see Joe doing this to other people, not having it done to him. What has Martin got in mind here? Oh no, he just tackled Crusoe into the wall. The wall just shattered. What has gotten into this kid? This is what the championship means to him. The fans are chanting, this is awesome. Hell yeah, what a way to start off Pulse. And ladies and gentlemen, I've completely forgotten this flurry of incredible offense by Martin Wittman. We got a television title match tonight. Jowell defends against Typhon of the Order. And that match that we talked about with Steven and Adam, they can earn their contracts, but they're going to have to beat the tag team champions, Seraph and Damien. So we just got an incredible show here tonight. Tucker, who you got in that match later? Who you rooting for?
Well, I mean, it's obvious who I got to root for.
I don't know. Steven had some words to say to me, but I feel like he was talking to you through me also. We've both said some things about the Gimps.
Oh, yeah, of course. I mean, I'm just absolutely disgusted by the way they would parade around the ring.
Exactly. But
it's completely disrespectful to the craft.
We're going to get to that later. Joe Crusoe now has got the match back in his control, looks like, with that hangman's neck breaker. But look at him. He's limping around the ring. He barely can even stand up straight. He's got the kid up, though. Irish whip. Oh, ribs first into that turnbuckle. Goes for a clothesline. Gets countered. Martin's getting back in this. And an elbow. That's how we started this matchup. Could it be how we finish it? No, he's not going for a pin. Stomps him instead. Looked a little bit low. I think it was to the gut, though. elbows to the shoulder. He's really working on that arm and neck area, it looks like, to set up for the Dragon Sleeper, which would be fatal if he could lock in that Dragon Sleeper on Joe. Once again, working on the arm. Kid's got a strategy here, and it could very well win him the biggest prize in wrestling today.
Getting Joe up. You don't have a chance.
Getting Joe up. I don't know. You're not impressed at all with what you've seen tonight?
No, not at all.
Oh, and he's got
Joe's
got
a punk.
Oh, no. He's going to hit this uppercut. There it
is. There it is.
He almost knocked his jaw off. Martin.
As it should be.
Martin could barely, he's barely moving his arms. I'm a little bit concerned. He might have got knocked out. No, he's getting up. Joe's telling him to get up. I think Joe's got something in mind. There it is. Oh, plants him back first with the rise and fall. He hooks the leg.
Too close to the rope, so he's going to grab it.
Got one. You got a two. Oh, no. Joe gets the win. He pulled that one out of nowhere because Martin Wittman had control of that match for at least 95% of the time. That's the thing in CME, though. Just one move, one big move is all it takes to put somebody down. And Joe pulled out his biggest move, which was the rise and fall. Tucker, did you get a little nervous there?
No.
You weren't feeling nervous at all. You were fully locked in behind Joe?
That's perfect fun.
I thought we might have seen a new chance. There was a chance, at least. But Joe pulls out a big win. Hopefully, for his sake, can get a little bit of a rest after this. But come on, the kid just fought the match of his life, and now, oh, not again. Another rise and fall after the match. Come on, Joe. There's no, good, all right, just leave now. Of course, why would it be so simple to just leave? You proved your point already. What did Wittman, I suppose this is for the pre-match attack by Martin Wittman, but.
Hey. You get what you bargained for.
He's still trying to get up. I would stay down if I was Martin.
I don't know. I don't think I'd stop him.
Oh my God! He got cracked. I think he's bleeding. Yep. He's got a cut on his head from that chair shot and right in the leg.
That's right, Joe. You bring him down.
Oh, Martin just springs up and
doesn't matter. Right
again.
Back down.
A brief glimmer of hope just put immediately down. And he is still getting up. How is this kid doing it? Why is he doing it? Joe with a suplex. This ain't a wrestling match. This is a beatdown. He pulled out a big suplex there. And Martin is crawling to his feet. Joe's just staring down at him.
Rise and fall.
I don't know if that's the third rise and fall. I don't know if he's getting up from that. The referee even felt the shaking of the ring there. Look at him stagger back. Yeah, this ref can't do anything about it. I wouldn't intervene with Joe. Joe again going under the ring for no reason whatsoever. This match is over. Do we have security or are they just completely gone tonight?
Yeah, they might be gone.
Bryce Phoenix said before this show that he would make his presence felt. I don't know where he is, but I would like to see him make his presence felt right now. Oh, my God. Bryce is fighting Joe for the championship at Bleeding Edge. But clearly, he doesn't want to intervene here for this kid. And you know what? I guess I don't blame him, but I'd like to see this. This is too. You condone this? It's a little bit too much, don't you think?
He got what he bargained for by attacking Joe before the match started.
Oh, man.
He should just be glad that Joe hasn't put his head against the ring post.
Martin, I got to respect him at least for trying to get up still, but. Please stay down. Kid, please just don't get up. I think you're just making Joe more angry. Not on the outside. Don't do anything on the outside, Joe. Joe is just staring down at this guy who will not give up. Even after the match is over. Oh, this Joe guy, he's got him by the back of his head here. Throws him against the wall. Once again, throws him back first into the wall. Look at the hatred in Joe's eyes. What? This is something beyond.
There it is.
This is something else that's on his mind.
That's another broken barricade.
The fans are chanting, this is awesome. All right. For being so behind Martin Wittman just 5 minutes ago, now they've completely turned to Joe. I guess this is awesome to them. Look at Joe mocking the kid. Tell him to get up from that one. I don't think he's going to get up from that one. And I think finally, Joe is finally leaving. Oh, my God. Well, up next, we got Salvaje versus Tiburon. Battle of the Luchadors. Tucker, we got this one up now, but coming up after this is Steven and Adam going for their contracts and their jobs back against Seraph and Damien. And then after that, the main event of the television championship. So we got a stacked card for you tonight. We kicked off the show with a world title match. That doesn't happen very often. You think Salvaje is going to shatter some dreams here tonight against Tiburon?
I don't know. Look at what happened to Salvaje last time.
Salvaje definitely got a taste of his own medicine.
No, he did. Not. And I don't know if he's going to be feeling so confident.
I don't know. Do you think that might have changed him? You think maybe he's going to try and do some other stuff instead of, you know, what we've seen from him? Or is he just going to keep going with the old status quo?
I think he's just afraid of pissing more people off, because I don't think he wants to feel his own medicine anymore.
No, that was absolutely devastating, and that put him away for the three count. So he lost, came up short at Autumn Blaze with his own move. If I'm him, maybe I won't do that anymore, but I can't get in this man's head. I don't know if I want to get in this man's head. He's certainly lives up to his name. Tiburon's got a lot to go after here tonight, but we have seen Jacob Harper in recent weeks look pretty impressive solo. So you think Tiburon can follow suit and have a good showing tonight?
Oh, well,
I think he's fully capable of it.
He's definitely capable of it. I generally think he's the stronger of the two.
Yeah, and Jacob Harper put a huge test in front of Jowell for the television title a few weeks ago. Tiburon can get a few wins together. Maybe we'll see him go after the television championship as well. I would not put it past him. Tiburon, though, it's been a while since we've seen him go solo, so this is going to be an interesting little experiment to see this man. Hey, we got a battle of the Luchadors. It's going to be a high-flying affair, ladies and gentlemen. That's for sure. He's coming out to the ring now. Tiburon, though, has the collapsing 450 as his signature move. The shark attack as well, but in terms of high-flying moves, he's got the collapsing 450. Salvaje's got the 630. We're going to have a lot of flips tonight, I think. So. I think if you're a betting man, I would put a lot of bets on high-flying in this one. I don't think we're going to see much groundwork. I'm surprised Salvaje did not, you know, start this thing a little bit early. We've seen him do that before. Here we go. Gonna get this one started. Salvaje immediately leaves the ring. Tiburon immediately jumps, but he misses. That is not what you want from Tiburon early. We've seen that.
You should start calling that move the rise and fall.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, just crash. We just call it crash and burns. That's what we've done on commentary a million times. And I think that's the record for the fastest crash and burn. And Salvaje catches a beautiful hurricane run off the apron. Now, Jacob Harper. We saw him, you know, reining in a little bit. We haven't seen too much of that from Jacob. But Tiburon clearly did not get the memo. But he's back in the ring now. He's going to try and get Salvaje catch him napping. Oh, Salvaje with the dragon screw leg whip. That's one way to slow down the offense. Tiburon with the jawbreaker. Misses a drop kick. Salvaje hits to the top. Tiburon catches him. What a knee to the face.
Oof.
Impressive jumping Hurricane Rana off the top rope.
He's still in this.
Nice body splash. Completely crisp the way he flies through the air. Another one. Beautiful move.
We're going for the four, I think.
There's the third one. Yeah, we're absolutely going to go for four, but this might be the hardest one of all. Look how far away he is.
Can you do it?
He's calling for it. Oh, my God, the 450. What a way to cap it off. He hooks the leg.
One. Two.
Oh, boy, that could be it. No. Salvaje. Tucker's losing his breath. That's how fast they're moving in there.
I don't even know how to keep up.
Uh-oh. Nice body splash. This time just from the ground itself. With a backflip. That's just showing off at that point. Gets him up. Tiburon looking pretty impressive after that high-flying flurry. Catches him.
Wow.
Beautiful swinging neck breaker. Salvaje gets out of the ring, and he's going to regroup. Is he going to leave? Oh, I think he's just going to play to the crowd a little bit. But he is probably not where he wants to be. Tiburon catches him that time with the corkscrew plancha. Hey, what doesn't work the first time? You just try and try again. He finally hit it this time on the second try. Nice, enziguri. Tiburon's looking pretty impressive so far, you know. Can't judge too early, but he's looking pretty good. Oh, but of course, face first goes into the ring post. Salvaje trying to get control back in this one. He's going up top. This is going to be a big shot. Oh, what a seated senton. He almost cleared the target completely, but he did manage to hit him with a, you know, with a tailbone.
Hurt him a little bit, though.
Definitely. They're both slower to get up. Tiburon actually is up before Salvaje. They're both in the ring now. Tiburon catches him with the clothesline. Salvaje springs up. Got him with a forearm. And another. Ducks under. Pele kick. Beautiful sequence by Salvaje. Oh, I thought he was going to go up top. He's got something else in mind. Standing shooting star press. Excuse me. Hooks the leg. And one. Could have a three. No. Tiburon's still in this one. These two giving each other a run for their money here. Really, this match is important for both men, for Tiburon to establish himself as a singles competitor, get some momentum, and Salvaje really just a rebound after the tough loss to Granada at Autumn Blaze. And he might... Oh, no. Is he going to go for it? We thought he might have been a changed man.
There he goes.
There's the cannonballs. I guess old habits die hard. Salvaje not making friends with Tiburon here tonight. Let's just say that.
Nor Tiburon's future grandchildren, if he can even have any after that move.
I see. I know exactly where this escalates, and I don't know if I'm going to like what I'm about to see. Tiburon certainly isn't. Tiburon in a precarious position.
Oh my God,
that's even worse. I don't know how it could be worse, but that is even worse. Well, there's only one more step left on this ladder, and this is a ladder of pain. Nice sunset flip. Beautiful move. That's not the move I was talking about, but if you've seen CME before or a Salvaje match, you know exactly what I'm talking about. He's getting him ready. Salvaje's got him where he wants him.
The ref's going to get out of the way.
I think the ref's trying to get him down. There's no reasoning with this man. He is just out of it. Oh, Tiburon is getting up. Salvaje's going to have to call an audible here, change up his move. Nice cross body. That's not the 630 Shattered Dreams, but it got him down. So it might have hurt Salvaje also. He's tough to get up right now.
All right, he's finally stirring.
He's crawling. So is Tiburon, though. They're both on an even plane here. Tiburon could not make it to his feet. Salvaje catches him. Oh, no. Tiburon with an elbow. He counters it. Kicks. Salvaje counters. Tiburon counters the spinning heel kick. Tiburon catches him. Nice victory roll. Beautiful counter.
One.
Got a one.
Two.
Oh no, that was almost a three. Tiburon almost took this one out of nowhere.
That's heartbreaking for Tiburon.
Oh no, is this this? Yes, the standing sliced bread number two. Hell, we've seen that from Salvaje, but we've also seen that from Tiburon's tag team partner, so he should have had that one a little bit more well scouted, I think. He's a little bit far away. Salvaje can't be going for it here, can he? Oh my God, he is. Oh no, he hit it! He flew three quarters across the ring. Just think the accuracy needed to do what he does. And that far away, that has to be a three count. He hooks the leg.
One, two, three.
That is it. It's almost, you know, it's almost certain that he's going to win after that move.
Yeah, it's textbook.
It's going to take either Duke Nukem or the Terminator. And I don't mean Joe Crusoe. I mean Arnold Schwarzenegger to kick out of that.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Joe could kick out of that.
I think maybe I would retire after somebody did that to me, honestly. This is the ending of a beautiful sequence. He hit that 450. He jumped a hell of a way, too, to hit that move. Let's not take anything away from Tiburon. Salvaje just came up big tonight. You think any of those crashing and burning, you know, hurt Tiburon early on in the match?
Oh, definitely. I'm hoping they're starting. Mean, but he didn't do it as often.
No, he definitely controlled himself more as the match went on. But he started the match off with a huge, huge fall. So it could have set the tone a little bit. I thought he did well to correct himself throughout the match, but you never know. These things can linger, and he took a huge 10-foot fall to the floor below.
Yeah, I mean, it might have taken him 5 minutes to start to feel it, but once he did, you know.
And I thought Tiburon
that was all she wrote.
I thought he had it here with his victory roll. He rolled him up out of nowhere, so I had to pull that kick out. And this is how it ended. Just look at the distance and the accuracy. It's almost... It's absolutely brutal, and it lives up to the name. It is savage, but it's also beautiful in a sick and sadistic way, I have to say. There's a reason why the people are cheering him.
There's a reason why we're cheering him.
I don't want to cheer, but it's hard to hate Salvaje. It actually is. He's great at what he does, but what he does is, I don't know. It's just something else. It's beyond description. Also beyond description might be what we're about to see next. Tucker, we touched on a little bit earlier, but I think you're firmly in the Seraph and Damien camp.
Oh, of course.
Well, here comes Stephen Parker and Adam Wright.
Hey, they're actually presenting themselves as a legitimate tag team coming up to the ring.
Well, they don't have music.
Yeah, well, I mean,
they're not actually wrestlers. I could have been
at least they're not coming out in pom-poms.
I mean, I could have been a dick, excuse my language, and giving them the old Gimps music, but I don't know. I at least I don't appreciate the tone that he presented with me, because I didn't hire these guys. You didn't hire these guys. They're the remnants of an old era of CME. Our previous general manager hired them and put them in gym suits. I didn't know what we were even getting into, so how was I supposed to know they didn't want to wrestle as Gimp Adam and Gimp Steve anymore? I thought that was just them. I thought they were into it. Did you have any?
I didn't really, they didn't let on.
If they had a problem with the way they were being presented, they could have come to me months ago and done this, but let bygones be bygones. They established themselves by beating the Tag Team Police Department. Let's see what they got. They're not in gimp suits anymore. They're not in latex. They've got
Why the
attitude.
Hell would they show up as Adonis and Stefan then? Because that's just a stupid.
It is. It is. I don't know. I have no idea, actually. That's a very good question. They weren't fooling me. I know they said that they didn't appreciate being treated like idiots, but I don't know. Maybe they just... Well, either way, let's see what happens. Because we have seen glimpses. We saw, let's call him Adam now. Let's call him Stephen Parker now. Let's call him by their name since they want to. We saw Adam show off fairly impressive strength against the TTPD at Autumn Blaze. Impressed me a little bit. We saw Stephen fly around before. We've always said that he had potential. So maybe now that they're not restricted by the, you know, the outfits. I mean, I probably wouldn't want to wrestle in a latex mask and an outfit either. So let's see how they do. But they have a huge task ahead of them with Seraph and Damien. These guys are the tag team champions. Damien puts Adam down immediately with a clothesline. Oh, Adam with a back body drop on Damien. Now, if you're Seraph and Damien, I know you know them very well. Are they sleeping on Adam and Steven? Because they cannot be.
I don't think so.
You think they're taking him seriously?
I think they'll take every threat seriously.
I would hope so. I mean, this is not for the Tag Team Championships. I will just say that right now. This is solely for Steve and Adam to win their contracts back. But if they can beat Seraph and Damien, hell, I think that immediately puts them in the Tag Team title picture, I would say.
I don't want to see it.
Well, we'll have to find out. Seraph going after the wrong man. Steve with a nice roll-up tilt-a-whirl into a small package.
One.
Oh, just catches him with a one count. And Steven knocks down Damien. Oh, and he's threatening to punch him in the face. Oh, nice counter of the dropkick. I don't know how he reacted that fast. He gets caught with an elbow, caught with a kick. Another one. Seraph's just beating him down the corner. They might have finally caught this guy. Oh, an alley-oop powerbomb. Now, Tucker, so we have two matches left in the show, both of them involving members of the Order. Bryce Phoenix has said that he will make his presence felt tonight. Is it going to be here, or is he going to wait for the title match? I don't know what he means by presence felt, but...
That could very well be.
Well,
I mean, honestly, if you're going to show up and cost for the match, I mean, I think what that's going to do to them psychologically.
If I was going to bet on what match or what, you know, part of the show he was going to get involved in, I would have immediately said whatever Joe Crusoe's doing, because Joe Crusoe is the man he's fighting for that championship at Bleeding Edge. But he did not show up, surprisingly.
In a two count. Show up. Dear God.
Yeah, I just realized that now. Adam, putting all his weight down, almost got Seraph down for a three count. But Bryce didn't make his presence felt when Joe was just annihilating Martin Wittman, who we do have being checked out by doctors backstage. Hopefully, he's not very badly injured. But with the way Joe beat him down, I would not be surprised if he was. Adam turns around and throws an unwitting Damien into the ring, but gets caught with an elbow by Seraph. Wouldn't bite off too much more than I can chew. I know I'm welcoming the Adam jokes now, but... Vicious elbows. by Seraph and an uppercut to put the big man
down. This is
down.
Just 1 week divorced from him destroying the ring.
Yeah. And Adams in a crippler crossface. Shout out to that old move. I'm surprised Seraph's breaking it out. I'm going to call that just a regular crossface from now on, but Seraph adopting a new submission style. I'm a little bit surprised he pulled that one out of his bag. Now, does that mean that, you know, what you said is true, that they're probably viewing them as threats to try and get him in a submission hold? They cannot pull a TTPD, that's all. That's all I got to say. I think everybody's learned their lesson from that. Adam with the Jackson Montgomery special. A lot of people are doing this one nowadays. But showing off his strength. Impressive strength there by Adam. He's getting him up now.
You think he's just like, he's just got a lot of muscle under there? Because, I mean, we have seen some pretty fat men with big muscle.
Yeah, absolutely. And we saw him throw around, I don't know if it was Tex or Avery. I'm going to have to check the tape again. But one of those, too. And that's not a small feat either. Oh, Adam, I thought he was going to go for a tag there. Gets caught. Seraph's going to the top. Oh, second rope, excuse me. Nice uppercut off the second rope. Adam absolutely needs to make a tag. He's been in there for far too long. Here comes Damien. Damien's going to stop him before he can even reach his partner. Adam with an elbow, though. These guys are fighting. They're just fighting for their lives, essentially. Their professional careers are on the line here. If they don't win,
no.
They're really not going to get another shot.
No. What are you doing?
I made sure to reinforce. Oh my god, he's standing on the ring post! And he gravity beat him to the punch on that one, but I don't know how he managed to survive on there as long as he did. I've made sure that this ring is extra reinforced. Just in case there was structural damage done last week. But I really hope he does not go to the top rope again.
It's just a bad idea.
Thankfully, everybody else in this match is far, you know, doesn't weigh as much as Typhon does, so hopefully that contributes to it. We could have a three count here. Oh, no. almost had a three count right in front of his own partner. That would have been even more embarrassing. But this is it. This really has to be it. The jokes are over now. The only reason they came back is Stefan and Adonis, because I thought it was funny, honestly. I had no reason to bring him back. But this is their last chance. If they want a contract here, they have to win this match. Oh, Steven gets punched in the face, knocked off the apron. Adam's up, though. He's coming back in. These guys are not going to give up. And he gets drop kick. Oh, my God. Did you feel the shaking of the floor?
Oh, God. Don't say we're going to break
the
floor.
Oh, my God. A springboard shooting star press. Adam is taking a whole hell of a lot of punishment right now. He's getting hoisted up. What strength! Damien with an elevated reverse DDT. And he takes Steven down with a clothesline. Damien's looking, incredibly impressive. These guys are the tag champs for a reason. Might not have liked the way they beat the Natural Perfection, but they did beat the Natural Perfection.
They did.
Irish whip by Adam. He's trying to get back in this. Gets caught with a jawbreaker. Oh no, is he gonna have he has the strength. There's that, the all fall down. That's it, that's gotta be it. He's hooking the leg. We got a one, Steven's in the ring. He breaks it up at two. He just barely saved his partner and they saved their chances at getting contracts. Look at Damien, he's furious. He is just stomping away at him. Adam catches him before he can get away. Oh no, we're going for a suplex now. Big man suplex, a nice vertical. Steven's in the ring, though. You can't make a tag with your partner in the ring next to you, but he's absolutely got to get out of this ring. We're going to hear another suplex. Here we go. Damien's down again. Steven's in his corner. This is the perfect opportunity. He's just, I don't know if he can even run to the corner, but he gets to there. And here comes Steven Parker. Uh-oh, float over.
Yes.
Nice DDT. Now, definitely the quicker of the two, and certainly the fresher. Beautiful moonsault. He twisted in the air. I'm not sure how he did it, but he did it, and he hooks the leg. We get a one. Not even a two count. Damien's not going to even take a chance at this one.
You think those latex outfits were stopping him from being able to do that?
I mean, we have seen him fly before, but not to the level of that. That was impressive. He did say, that was a thing. I mean, I would just die from the embarrassment, honestly, if I was coming out there. Oh, Steven slaps him in the face. That's not how you endear yourself to the order, but they're not in the business of making friends. They're in the business of making money, and they're going to have to win this match if they want to keep any kind of chance of making money alive.
They're definitely doing the greenback boogie, and he's wiping his
look at that
foot with it.
He's washing the boot on his face. Steven getting up with a jawbreaker. Nice counter. Gets Irish whipped. Damien, though, running at him. Hits him with a forearm splash in the corner. Damien, he's not one, he's not a stranger to flying either. We've seen it tonight. We might see it again. Elbow drop misses. Steven with a springboard moonsault. There goes Seraph. Oh my God, he's got the opportunity. No, what is he doing? Oh my God. I think he hit Seraph with the leg drop, but he certainly took a lot of punishment on his back there. That was a huge fall. Damien follows suit. My God. Springboard shooting star.
His body's ever on the outside.
He might have broken his spine with that move. That is not good. Lillian and the bald timekeeper just saw their lives flash before their eyes. Oh no, this is not a smart move. You hit him with the chair, they win by disqualification. They get contracts. Steven's up though, he's gonna follow him. He elbows Seraph off the apron. I don't think Seraph saw it coming. Nice. Oh, how did he do that so fast? Here comes his partner. I don't know if Adam had enough time to recover, but certainly he's gotten some rest. Oh no, not again. Not again. Don't pull this one out. This is not going to be good. No! Oh! He just knee dropped him in the head. He didn't jump. He more fell, but he just hit Damien with the leg right across the face. I can't believe he's getting up. I'm surprised his face is in tatters. Oh no, not this. Is he going to make him tap out to this? The reverse Boston Crab. He's right by the ropes though. Steven's trying to get in. Not going to save him. Oh, Adam just manages to get free just in the nick of time. What do these guys got to do to beat them? They have not found the formula. Oh, wait a minute.
Hey, you hear that?
That's Bryce Phoenix's music.
Basically, what I'm going to make sure, nobody in the order is holding any gold. And the only thing that they're going to have to hold on to at night to keep themselves feeling okay about themselves is each other's cocks.
Oh, come on!
Bryce Phoenix just came over the PA system. I don't condone that language, but wait a minute, we got to roll up in the ring. Damien was caught off guard. Oh my God.
Are you kidding me?
I cannot believe this.
No!
Say hello to your new tag team, ladies and gentlemen, Steven Parker and Adam Wright. Oh my God.
Are you kidding me?
I need a sip of water, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me. I need to douse myself in flames too. What the hell did we just see? I guess we know what Bryce Phoenix meant by making his presence felt. He certainly made his presence felt through the intercom.
You didn't fire that man who gave me access to the intercom.
Whoever let him into the production truck can answer to Tucker. Wow.
You're fired.
What a...
Pack your shit and get out of here.
This is it. Damien was anticipating Bryce to come through the crowd, I guess. He was listening to what he was saying. Turns around as Bryce is done. And Adam was in the ring waiting for him. Rolls him up. Look at this. The weight of the world was on Damien's shoulders right here. There was no way he was getting out of this pretzel. Oh, my God. We've got some new wrestlers. Same as the old wrestlers, but probably even better. Look at this. Tucker, you can cool down during the break because we got a hell of a main event coming up. I don't know if anything can follow this one, though, but we're going to see as Jowell defends his newly won television title that he won last week against Typhon. Don't know if I want to be Jowell coming up next. So, Tucker, are you doing okay now? We've had a little break.
I'm disgusted.
Not doing okay. What if Typhon wins the television title? You gonna feel a little bit better?
Okay, but we'll feel better then.
But Bryce Phoenix did say over the intercom that he will stop at nothing until every member of the order does not have gold. We could have a double dip of Bryce Phoenix tonight. I wouldn't be surprised if he comes out during this one. But Typhon is a man on a mission, essentially.
No, you can't distract Typhon.
He's the only one.
People have tried and people have failed.
Oh, absolutely. This man is the only one in the order without a title. And there's only one title left for him to win. That is the television title. So Jowell might not, I mean, I'm sure he's happy that he beat Lewis last week, and Lewis has a mild concussion after that match, so he's going to be out for a couple of weeks. But I don't know maybe if he would have wanted to win the title knowing that Typhon was his next opponent. Just a week after this man beat Bryce Phoenix at Autumn Blaze and absolutely destroyed Adam within an inch of his life and destroyed the building, the ring was in pieces. Don't know if I like Joel's chances in this one. I know you got Typhon winning, obviously. It's hard to bet against this man. As an outsider, I'm not a part of the clique here. But as an outsider, I cannot bet against him. I can't.
That's good, because if you were to bet against him, he'd probably beat you down.
Probably. That's another reason why I'm not. But here comes Jowell, and I got no love lost for this man. But I will say this. He's a credible champion, for sure. He's a two-time television champion now. He's beaten the crap out of me, although I caught myself there. But, of course, Bryce Phoenix brings the adult audiences in with his language. But this man has no... I'm trying to think of the best way to say this. He's got no lack of talent, is what I'm trying to say. But I don't know if talent is enough to beat Typhon. I think
he doesn't have talent.
You got to dig down.
He's a punk. I mean, he lost in 3 minutes to Luis.
He did get caught off guard by Luis. But the next night, he didn't jump Luis. He wrestled a straight match, and he came up big. So hopefully, looking down at that title, might be the last time he sees it. Throws the title on the ground.
Oh, come on.
Oh, my God. Jowell just clubs Typhon in the face.
So you might argue that Martin Wittman, what he did, was not intentional, but that was intentional. That was so disrespectful.
That was no jump, though. Typhon saw him come, and he was looking him right in the eyes, and Jowell looked in the eyes of the monster and said, I want some. But he might have gotten some now, because Typhon is clubbing away at him. Jowell back body drops him. Almost over the ropes, Typhon catches himself, and he elbows Joel in the face. Might have been smart. Might have been dumb, but it also was pretty brave, I think, the way Joel started this thing off. But it doesn't look like it really took Typhon down at a couple pegs. Might have made him a little bit more mad than he already was. He's got to change his strategy fast now before he gets caught with another red right hand and put out for good. That might not be the strategy, though, but he can get himself disqualified. It would keep his title. Typhon catches the chair, though, throws it down on the ground. Oh, no, we're going to see this uppercut. Look at this. Oh, my God. And he falls down through all three ropes. Ref's got to get that chair out of there. There he goes. Good job, referee. Typhon, beautiful Northern Lights suplex. Like I said, this guy can not only beat you up, he can wrestle you, too. He's a jack of all trades for a man his size. Jowell springs up to his feet, clotheslines Typhon. Look at this. He got a second wind. Nice power slam. Snap power slam by the television champion. Hooks the leg. We got a one. Not enough to keep him down for two, though, but had a nice flurry there. He's got to build on it. Jowell has to build on this if he wants to keep him down. But look at him. He's already getting up slowly. Oh, going for that wheel. No, the wheelbarrow German suplex. That could have very well killed the momentum dead in its tracks for Jowell. Here, Typhon getting him up now. Nice drop kick. The way he gets up in the air is like a light heavyweight, but the man's over 300 pounds. Counter, Jowell with a left hand of his own. And he gets caught with a brutal headbutt. A red right hand, that's gotta be it.
That's it.
He's not going for the cover though. Jowell rolls out of the ring. Probably a smart move. He can't get pinned out there. I'm surprised his lights aren't turned out for good, though. He's going up the stairs. Maybe not the best strategy because Typhon's there to catch him. Belly to bellies him into the ring. That's not looking good for the TV champ, though. But like I said, we said it with Joe Crusoe earlier. One big move is all you need. And you know what? Typhon might have just hit one big move with that suplex, and he's going for another one. Oh, he's going for that devil may care. Oh. Drops him on the top of his head.
That's got to be it.
If the red right hand didn't knock him out, that surely will. Look at the way
Typhon,
he landed.
Come get your gold.
Unbelievable. Hooks the leg. We could have a new champ here. We got a one.
Two.
Jowell grabs the ropes. Wait.
Doesn't matter. Ref didn't see it.
We got a new television champion. Questionable circumstances.
I don't care.
Let's see that replay again. I want to see that replay, but replay or not, there's no reversing this decision. Typhon is your new television champion, and the Order now have every single title in CME. Jowell had a nice flurry of offense, started this one off hot, hit that power slam, and that's the closest he ever got to beating Typhon with a one count. Look at that. Now, here we go. This is the end.
Oh, God, this is beautiful.
He almost broke his neck with that move. Let's see this. Let's see if this came in before three, the rope break. Got that one there. Got two. Grabs the ropes, then a three count. It was a split-second decision. I don't blame the ref for not seeing it, but Jowell did grab the ropes.
Doesn't matter. All the Order's got gold. Come on, guys. Let's go celebrate. We'll actually go to Pumps.
You might see Bryce Phoenix there if he frequents that destination. But ladies and gentlemen, the Order are in control of CME. I don't know if I like it very much.